Save the date, July 29th for .NET Conf, focus on F#. Join us for this free one-day live stream event that features speakers from the community and Microsoft teams working on and using the F# language. Learn how F# lets you write succinct, performant, and robust code backed by the powerful type system and .NET runtime you can trust to build mission-critical software. Hear from language designers and experts using F# in a variety of ways, from building minimal web APIs to performing data manipulation, interactive programming, machine learning, and data science. Tune in on July 29th, ask questions live, and learn more about what F# can do for you.
Join us for this episode of Phone.net. I've got JP, my very good friend JP, to talk to us about migrating to modern authentication in .NET. See you soon. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another On.NET show. Today, again, I have my very good friend JP to talk to us about migrating to modern authentication. And this is a very hot topic because a lot of things are happening around the .NET space. We have .NET 6 coming, quite a few changes around the identity space as well since last September. So we have JP here to tell us why, how, and where to go next. Hey, JP, how are you doing, my friend?
Hey, Christo, how are you? Fancy seeing you here. It's been a while.
Long time no speak since yesterday afternoon.
Yeah. So yeah, we're gonna talk about app migration today. I mean, it's a huge thing that people have to do. It's a lot of work, takes a lot of effort, and because everybody's app is a little bit different, right? Everybody's app is using identity in some way or another, and migrate might mean one thing to one person and something completely different to somebody else. So we're gonna take a look at a few things that we've got. To make that a little bit easier.
Yes. Now, tell me a little bit about, I mean, we're talking about Microsoft Identity, right? Not just any identity. Specifically, we're talking about Microsoft Identity. Why is it so important right now to start looking about migrating?
Well, I think we've got some timelines that are coming up that are changing. Things like there's an old library called ADAL, Active Directory Authentication Library. That ADAL library is going to be deprecated next summer. So summer of 2022, that library is going to be deprecated, and it's already not getting any new enhancements, only security fixes right now. So everything that we have has been migrated to the Microsoft Authentication Library, which of course we call MSAL. And MSAL is available for lots of different languages, JavaScript, .NET, Java, Objective-C, all sorts of different languages and platforms, which you need to build it in. And it's got a ton of new features keep you up to date with where the identity industry is going and best practices for security and all that sort of fun stuff.
So more security updates. It's going to be the current one. So MSAL is going to be the de facto one. I mean, it's been for the last few years anyway, but people have been slow in migrating. It adds some additional capabilities that ADAL did not support out of the box before, right? So yeah. How hard? I mean, I know that every software is a little bit of a snowflake, and every piece of code that you write is special, right? You're never going to have two identical things, but I suspect there are some common patterns to allow developers to migrate from the old code to the new code.
Yeah, so I think if we look at sort of these, especially some like older .NET apps, and if you're in the middle of an ASP.NET framework to .NET Core type of a migration, or I guess it's not even called .NET Core anymore, right? .NET 5 will just be straight up .NET. If you're in the middle of one of those, because you're going to be in the guts and you're going to be making a bunch of code changes anyway, it's actually a really good time to start looking at what your alternatives might be. and we've got a few different things to take a look at now when it comes to identity. So, of course, there's ASP.NET Identity as exists today, and ASP.NET Identity offers a lot of sort of base functionality. And if you're migrating from ASP.NET Identity or if you want to upgrade that, there are still lots of ways to use ASP.NET Identity and Azure AD and Microsoft Identity sort of together, right? So things like OWN and the like, you can still use Azure AD as an identity provider into ASP.NET Identity. Mm-hmm. So as you're migrating off of that, you know, old membership database into something like Azure AD, you can go ahead and start doing that migration without blowing up all of your identity code.
Nice.
In fact, you and I did a show on that almost a year ago today, right? Of migrating from, migrating from one to the other.
And there'll be a blog post following this one to summarize the links and everything else that we're going to be covering today, so people can go and directly look at that and get an idea of what they need to do in the coming months.
Yeah. So I think, you know, if you're coming from ASP.NET Identity, you've kind of got a lot of work ahead of you, for lack of a better term. If you're coming from ADAL, however, from ADAL, the ADAL to MSAL migration is a lot more straightforward. ADAL is a lot of the concepts that were in ADAL were carried over into MSAL, and MSAL is sort of a, you think of it as sort of like an ADAL plus. It's got a lot of new features and a lot of more of a modern design behind it. But the API surface is still pretty similar. So if you're used to things like the authentication context for getting tokens or for signing in users, the authentication context is still there. We just call them confidential client applications now. There are some docs that we've got already. So we've got one doc that's all about migrating from MSAL.NET to Microsoft.Identity.Web. And that's something we haven't actually talked about yet. If we look at the libraries that we have, we've got ADAL, and we've got MSAL now. And MSAL is purely a token acquisition library. It's just for us to go to the identity service, get a token, cache it, and do some stuff with it. But it's just for getting tokens. Doesn't necessarily sign in a user, because we're going to typically, in .NET world anyway, we're going to defer to things like ASP.NET to actually do the mechanics of signing in the user.
Right.
Because ASP.NET's going to do things like redirect the user to go sign in and then validate their token and write a cookie, for example. ASP.NET itself is going to do that, whereas when we need a token to go call our graph service or to call your own API, that's what we traditionally use MSAL for.
Okay.
Historically, that's kind of been a pain to have to wire up. I mean, I don't want to be, you know.
There were two different distinct systems, right? ASP.NET would do the sign in, and then you had MSAL to go and acquire your tokens, and you had to wire them separately, and they were not particularly nice in playing together.
And it was, it was not a super great experience. In fact, I got a little bit of code up here on the screen. We'll take a look at this. So, if we look at some, so we got a little bit of older code here, and this uses the OpenID.
That's all. Yeah.
I mean, look at things like global ASAX. Like, this is like archaeology right now.
Yeah.
But we've got things like that we're using OpenID Connect as the, which is sort of the protocol that we use in Azure AD for sign in. We're using OpenID Connect, and we're letting ASP.NET handle, and in this case, ASP.NET ON is handling all of the interaction with the OpenID Connect upstream. Right. But you'll notice we have things down here like authorization code received, this method here, and this this delegate that we have to write. Now we're like taking what ASP.NET's doing, and then we're pulling in MSAL, and we're saying, hey, MSAL, you should go and redeem this token or redeem this authorization code so I can go get a token and stuff it into the cache and do all that. And it's a lot of interactive work, and it requires you as the developer to have a lot of protocol knowledge, I guess is the right way to describe it. Like, you need to understand what an authorization code is. You need to understand when in the pipeline you're going to get that authorization code, how to handle it, and then caching the results of it. Because when you get the authorization code, you probably don't actually necessarily need that token right then, right? So this whole blob of code, which is a fairly considerable amount of code.
90 lines, as I can see, or more or less.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of code, right? It starts at line, it starts at line 34 and goes to line, goes to line 96. So it's a lot of code.
Yeah.
If we look at a more modern version of this, however, we'll see that the code that we need to do the exact same thing, which is to redeem authorization codes and put those into caches and do all that sort of work, has been reduced to really one line of code, but it's just on four lines to make it easier to read.
Snap.
Yeah.
That is amazing.
Yeah, so our first line here, our add authentication, this is what handles wiring up the ASP.NET core side of the house. So the ASP.NET or the ASP.NET core side is the thing that actually still handles the OpenID Connect today. So it's still going to be the thing that handles your redirect to Azure AD and signing in and then handling your ID token when it comes back and issuing cookies and doing all that work. So for sign-in, ASP.NET is still our sign-in thing. It's still going to do our sign-in for us. Nice. But, and we're going to configure that with lines 32 and 33 that are up here on the screen.
Yep.
Lines 34 and 35, that is everything that we need to wire up and get an MSAL client to handle acquiring tokens, to handle caching those tokens so that I can use them later on. And you as the developer don't have to have this really deep understanding of the workflow of OpenID or of OAuth2 in order to be able to process that. And in fact, even on line 35, you notice we say we're using in-memory token caches. Those in-memory token caches, of course, are they're going to be recycled as soon as your worker process recycles or whatever. But if you're using an iDistributed cache in ASP.NET Core, you can use one of those and plug those in right here. So this will use distributed caches automatically. You don't have to worry about writing your own caching, caching handlers, caching mechanisms. All that's handled for you by the Microsoft.Identity.Web library that lives on top of MSAL. So it sort of handles the ASP.NET configuration and the MSAL configuration, and then gives you this cool, really, really simple API to work with. Yeah.
Yeah. So ASP.NET solves a lot of problems. So if you are working on ASP.NET, then that's awesome. But there's also desktop apps, there's mobile apps with Xamarin that are all built with .NET. And so all these, if they are still using ADAL, they need to be migrated to MSAL. And there we don't have Microsoft.Identity.Web because it is web only. Yep. But there's Microsoft.Identity client, which is the MSAL equivalent in the namespaces. And that allows, so they also need to be migrated, not just the web apps, just to make it clear.
Yeah, that's true. So anything that's using ADAL definitely needs to be migrated to MSAL, preferably as soon as possible. So we announced the deprecation last summer.
Yep.
And, you know, there are lots of, there's still lots of apps that are using it. And, you know, we're working to try to reduce that number. The other thing is you may be using it and you don't know it. You may be using it if you're taking a dependency on a library or a package that does use it. And so out of NuGet, of course, we've been taking a look at some of the data out there to see what kinds of packages are still using ADAL and helping them migrate. It's a lot of first party teams here at Microsoft we've been talking to about, okay, it's time to move on over to MSAL. And so those should start to resolve themselves. But if you're working on an open source library, if you're consuming a library from a vendor or from another company, particularly one that maybe isn't super, super, super big, where it's got a lot of, or it has a ton of users. Great idea to take a look at that and see what we can do about migrating that one over, because this time next year, it's going to get a little sticky.
Yes. Your apps will still continue working, but we would highly encourage you to move on to MSAL, considering that ADAL will not be getting any updates, any new features and what have you. And as we said, MSAL already provides you with a ton of new capabilities and features that are not part of ADAL anymore. So where should developers go next? Like if they saw this video and they're like, oh man, we need to start moving ASAP, where should they go to make their next steps?
So we have some new docs, which is super cool. So we got some new docs all about migrating to MSAL, migrating MSAL from or to Microsoft.Identity.Web. We've got some brand new docs that are out. These have just came out within the last like 6 or 8 weeks. Mm-hmm. So we've got this one, and we'll have links to these in the description. And we'll also have links on our blog that we're going to write about this later. So we've got migrating your applications to MSAL and Identity.Web. Same for confidential client apps, so things like your like if you've got a console app, or if you do have not a desktop app, because that wouldn't be a confidential client, but confidential clients where you're using things like client credentials or other types of applications that maybe aren't necessarily web apps, but where you can keep a secret, Windows services, et cetera, that sort of thing. Linux service doesn't have any Windows, but so we've got a bunch of new docs that are out here. They're all under this tree of migrating to MSAL, to MSAL.NET.
Okay.
And so you can take a look at what the differences are, especially when you get into mobile. Mobile gets a little interesting because there are lots of different interaction mechanisms in mobile and lots of different expectations people have for interaction in mobile. Do I open a system view? Do I open a web view? Do I use a broker like the Authenticator app? And MSAL supports a whole lot more of those scenarios than ADAL did. And so there are different, lots of specifics, especially around around mobile apps, so that you can get a closer experience. And of course, if you're using Azure AD or if you're using B2C, Azure AD B2C, everything still applies here. So ADAL is going to be going away. MSAL is the way to go. Regardless of what kind of app you're using, we want you to move away. There are lots of new advantages to things like authorization code with Pixie. That's a new flow that's not an ADAL that is in MSAL. And as OAuth 2.1 starts to get more traction and starts to get ratified and new grants and new flows start to come out, all of those enhancements and improvements are going to go into MSAL and not in ADAL. So
dynamic consent, V2 endpoints, and all the goodness that you would get from the latest and greatest. Now, if people get stuck and they don't know what to do next, like I read the docs, but I'm still not sure what I need to do. Is there somewhere that they can go to get help?
Yeah, it's a Christo's dot. Oh, sorry. So you can come and ask us. We've got Microsoft Q&A. Microsoft Q&A is our, I think it's a kind of a newer thing, right? Where you can go and ask questions and get help.
It's a new forum, right? They rebranded everything. So it's a new forum where you can go and directly speak to our support team. We have 40 engineers, I think, sitting there waiting to answer your questions and help you out. But we also have our Discord, the 45 show Discord. We also have a stream. So if you actually want to ask questions live to me and JP about identity, then Tuesdays and Fridays, 8 a.m. Pacific on the 45 show on Twitch, you can come and actually talk to us about things. And we've done migrations, and we'll probably be doing more migrations over the next few weeks as we try to get more people up to date. But if you've seen this video, then at least now you know that you need to start migrating your apps and benefit from the latest and greatest. I want to thank JP for coming here. The links to the repo that JP was showing, the links to all the migration documents, plus the links to the blog will all be available at the description below. So thanks everyone for tuning in, and we'll see you soon again.